What is in vivo coding? When is it helpful? And how do you do in vivo coding when using a qualitative analysis tool? In this Delve video, we will answer those questions. In vivo coding is helpful in that early phase of your qualitative data analysis when you're still deciding what to code and figuring out what to name the codes that you create. There are a number of coding methods that are helpful at this phase, but let's talk about just one of them. In vivo coding is a first cycle coding method in qualitative analysis where you derive codes from the data itself. In vivo codes utilize the actual words and language that your participants use when they're describing their own experiences. This is in contrast to other coding methods where you might use your own words as a researcher to name your codes. Let's dive into an example of how to do in vivo coding using the Delve Qualitative Analysis tool. Before you start coding, make sure you have your transcripts loaded into the tool. I just have 5 in-depth interviews here, and I'm going to go in and start reading. So over here, Gary says, because I think that's one of the fears with people doing interview research, is that they go, I'm going to make such a mess, and it's going to feel overwhelming. And it's going to be like, why did I do this? So the thing that's standing out to me here is he says, feel overwhelming. And I really want to capture Gary's perspective there. So I'm going to turn the words that he used into a code called feel overwhelming. So I just created that code, and there it is, my first in vivo code. Let's go through another one. So I'm going to kind of read through, and then as I find things that are interesting, over here he says, by doing all that work, now they have trust in us. Even though I've been working with them for 10 years, but different people come in and take over, and I've been in corporate. So over here, he's talking a lot about that trust that he's built. So I'm going to highlight that section there. Actually, I'll highlight a bigger section. And I'm going to create a new code called Trust in Us, where I used the words that he used, and I'm capturing his perspective. And there's my second in vivo code. Now, once you make these in vivo codes, you want to make sure you also apply it to other data segments as well. So I'm going to look at other transcripts and then see other instances where people felt overwhelmed or they were talking about how they built trust in themselves. And when I'm doing this now, these participants don't literally have to use the same words like how I was capturing it before. But I want to make sure that I'm still capturing the perspective of the participant. So over here, Alyssa says, yeah, I use it actually for a lot of my client projects, assuming I have the time for it. I have this project now that's only 3 weeks and I feel like I'm drowning in it with such a tight deadline. So she says, I'm drowning in it with such a tight deadline. So I feel like her perspective there is that she's also feeling overwhelmed. So what I'm going to do is highlight that section, click on feel overwhelmed, and now I've coded something else with the code that I created with an in vivo method. Make sure to use in vivo coding along with other first cycle coding methods, such as descriptive or process coding when you're coding your transcripts. You can learn about these other ways to code in our other videos at delvetool.com/learn. And then try out in vivo coding for yourself using the Delve Qualitative Analysis tool. You can do that by starting a free trial at delvetool.com/get-started.